Buru Energy's Eric Streitberg joins us now from the Perth studio. Eric, good to see you.
And it's a pleasure, Danielle. Always great to talk to the proactive people.
Thanks very much. Well, we're excited to have you on today because you've just announced major transactions at your Ungani Oilfield with Roc Oil. Tell us all the highlights and all the details.
Well, the highlights, I guess, are the fact that we had 100% of Ungani, and we've done a deal with Roc Oil, who are owned by a Chinese company called Fosun International, to purchase half the field for $64 million. And on the back of that, there's a farming agreement for us to drill up to four wells, with Roc carrying us for about $20 million of a $25 million program. So it's a major step forward for our company.
And can you tell us, what is the motivation behind this deal? It's not something that you had to do by necessity. You were on track to production targets, of course. The oil price still over 100 Australian dollars a barrel. So what motivated you to bring on this partnership?
Yes, well, we came through the valley of death in 2016 when the oil price went down to $30. And like everybody, we restructured our business and we're now in a position where we can move it forward. But we didn't have the balance sheet to really accelerate things as much as we'd like to. The lifeblood of any company like ours is finding more oil and producing more oil. And that, of course, requires capital. So this seemed like a good time to bring in a partner who had a big balance sheet and was able to help us move the project forward more quickly than we would have been able to do it with our internal resources.
And of course, it saves you from having to go back to market to raise that money. So tell us, now that you have the cash to play with, how does that affect your near to medium term exploration plans exactly?
Yes, well, we've been looking to drill three to four wells this year, but of course, we're in a position where we couldn't really fund all of them in the one program. So this allows us to accelerate that program and to drill our three wells at least this year. And then we have a very big prospect called Raphael that we want to drill next year. It's a more expensive well, and we wanted to make sure we had enough cash on the balance sheet so that if it turned out to be a bit more expensive than we thought, we wouldn't get caught short. So this really sets us up well for the exploration program.
And beyond the exploration, what is your longer term business model?
Very simple. Find more oil and produce it. So, and this transaction really does help us to do that. Small companies in the business like ours are always underfunded. And this was a real opportunity for us to change that and be able to drive the company forward. So we can grow either organically. We've got a terrific exploration portfolio even after we've farmed out 50% of it. And it also gives us the firepower to do other things that add value to the business, like different export routes, local processing, even getting into other areas. So it really gives us the flexibility that we didn't have before.
In the very near term now, bringing you back to today, what are the next key news flows that your shareholders and stakeholders should be staying tuned for?
Well, certainly keeping our production up. We've got a target of 3,000 barrels a day. We're currently doing about 2,600. Of course, we've now sold half of that, so we'll be entitled to 1,300 barrels a day, going up to 1,500. So that's obviously a target that we need to meet to keep the cash flow coming in. And then getting ready for the drilling program, which will start probably in August this year. So another couple of months. Now we've done the deal, we have to get on and get everything ready to start the drilling program. We've got some very exciting prospects to drill.
Well, Eric, congratulations on the announcements this week and very good luck with all the rest of it. We look forward to having you back to keep us updated.
Thank you very much.